What's going on, everybody? Fung Bros here.
Richie Lee.
And if you guys didn't know by now, we absolutely love basketball and the NBA.
Love it. The 2014-2015 NBA season is coming up, starting on October 28th. So that basically means we are hella excited.
I love this game. It seems that Asian American guys love basketball.
But why?
But like, is it because we're like really good at it or something?
No.
Is it because there's a bunch of Asian guys on TV talking about basketball?
No.
Is it because basketball is like a sport from Asia or something?
No.
So why do we like it so much? That's a complicated question for a different video.
So in this video, we're gonna be talking about our favorite teams, favorite players, our predictions, and rumors that we've heard about the upcoming NBA season in the first episode of
Asian Guys Talk About the NBA. Woo! Okay, to start it off, let's talk about the top four teams in both the Western and Eastern Conference. Since we're in the West, let's start off with our predictions.
I got the Spurs, I got OKC, I got Golden State. With the fourth, I'm going with Portland.
For me, I'm going with, of course, OKC, Spurs, Clippers at number three, and Warriors at number four.
So my picks are pretty much the same as yours, except I got Memphis at number four.
All right, now let's talk about the Eastern Conference. Right now, which is considered much weaker than the Western Conference overall, I think most people would agree that we got Cavs, Bulls, Wizards, and Raptors.
Richie don't like the Raptors.
Richie don't like the Raptors.
I don't know. I replace the Raptors with the Heat.
East is so bad that they got a shot. You know what? They have expectations.
The Heat have winning expectations. OKC.
They always have a shot with Westbrook and Durant, but if you made me choose, I'd say Westbrook's kind of the problem. You can't win playing hero ball.
What are some of our favorite moves from Kevin Durant and Russell Westbrook?
Durant's cross-court flush.
The Russell Westbrook super rigid three-pointer. The Spurs. Wait. Why are we not gonna talk about them?
Man, nobody wants to talk about teamwork.
Clippers.
They're super talented, but they just throw way too many alley-oops to ever make it that far in the playoffs.
Believe me,
I love the fact that Jamal Crawford threw the under the legs alley-oop to Blake Griffin.
Coming up in the number one spot, we've got Jamal Crawford to Blake Griffin. Warriors. It's like one of those teams that's gonna post a good regular season record and then probably lose in the playoffs.
It pays off so much to be exciting during the real season. You make so much money, it's fun, it's more marketable.
It's so silly, but it's so fun.
So fun.
Cavs. I know a lot of people think this, but I really think the Cavs might win the championship this year.
They got Love, Kyrie Irving, they got LeBron James, Varejao.
Hold up.
Mike Miller.
Oh!
In the future, Kyrie Irving to LeBron James.
Oh, Kyrie with the shade.
Oh!
Kevin Love, full court outlet pass.
It's made, and he gets it.
The Bulls. D. Rose, former MVP, can he even return to 80% of his former self?
They got a legacy, they have high expectations, they got a lot of pressure. Derrick Rose, super athletic, crazy layup.
First cross. Wizards. Nobody thought that you would say the word Wizards for top four in the East.
I'm pretty impressed by John Wall's like leadership that he's grown into. I think that's really cool. Coming out of college, you know, he's doing like the John Wall dance. He seemed kind of like a kind of wild dude.
John Wall. John Wall behind the back, left-handed dunk. Raptors.
Drizzy.
You know, they got the Drake cosign, which means actually nothing, but
no, that's
but
huge. Yeah, man, they're gonna win it, man. Shut up.
Drizzy.
We love Drake. Drake generation, OVO. I don't think they're going to win the championship, but yes, I do think they're going to do pretty well in the East again.
All right, now let's talk about some teams that are notable, but definitely not going to be in the top four in either conference.
The Lakers. They got Jeremy Lin. We're really excited about that.
I know a lot of people want to say that he sucks. A lot of people want to say that he's Linsanity all the time. I'm just going to cheer for him. I'm going to watch every single Lakers game. Jeremy Lin reverse layup.
Hey.
Rockets.
They got a lot worse.
Obviously, people are gonna accuse us of hating the Rockets, especially because they did Jeremy dirty, but nah, I mean, the Rockets got worse.
Dwight Howard rigid power dunk, like a Jaeger. still no post moves, moving like a big robot. My favorite, the Knicks. Carmelo Anthony pull-up jumper. Who's open? Who's open?
The Suns and Mavs.
Okay, I feel like the Suns and Mavs are two talented teams, but just because the West is so stacked, they can't do anything.
Gerald Green, anything.
Brooklyn Celtics and Pacers.
I feel really bad for the Pacers. They lost two of their best players.
Shout out to Rodney Stuckey. Growing up, we played on the same basketball team. He was the year ahead of me, so we knew each other. We're friends. Just to grow up with somebody who made it to the NBA, of course you're gonna root for him. All right, Celtics and Brooklyn, two really old teams, and I don't know. I mean, who really cares about them?
Rajon Rondo tip-off routine.
Asians in the NBA.
So aside from Jeremy Lin, you got Jordan Clarkson, who's half Filipino. You got Simbu Lar, he signed to the Kings and he's of Indian descent.
He nice.
And then the Japanese guy, Yuki Togashi, he played in Summer League.
He didn't make the team though. Let's just show you a few clips of Yuki Togashi in
impressive.
Summer League. Because
it's impressive.
It was pretty cool. You know, at one point, there was like five Chinese guys in the NBA. You had Yi Jianlian,
Dun Ye, Wang Titi, I think was still in.
Yao Ming, and Menge Batir. All in the NBA at the same time. That's crazy.
NBA issues.
So you got racist owners, Clippers, Atlanta Hawks, they had to sell it.
Owners are getting canned. Not only that, I think you have the huge imbalance of power between the East and the West.
Well, Cleveland kind of brings us to the issue of all these super teams. All the old school players are like, man, back in my day, we just won with the team we had, man.
I think another interesting issue is Kobe's in his final two seasons in the NBA. What's gonna happen to the NBA after he retires?
He's gonna look to his right, see Jeremy Lin, a Chinese man. He's gonna pass the Lakers on to Jeremy Lin, man.
Yeah. And last but not least, we have to give our NBA Finals prediction. I'm gonna go with Spurs over Cavs.
I'm just gonna go with the Cavs.
I like the Cavs, but I'm gonna go with OKC.
Who do you got? All right, you guys, thank you so much for watching our very first episode of Asian Guys Talk About the NBA.
We hope you guys learned something. Let us know if there's anything else you want us to talk about.
A group of Asian guys talking about the NBA, that's something you will not see on ESPN.
See you, think I can. Oh! Thank you everybody for watching that video. Richie just dunked on me. We just love basketball and the NBA. And you know, we just make videos about things that we like and that we're really interested in. So watch this video, subscribe to our channel. Let us know if you like this video and let us know if you want to see more clips of us dunking on a 7-foot hoop.